The term Super Tuscan represented the renaissance of Italian wine during the 1970s. The term was used by the Anglo-Saxon press in the 1990s to describe those Tuscan wines which were no longer only based on Sangiovese, but were actually produced as a blend of Sangiovese and other international varieties, and were therefore labeled as vino da tavola. As an example, I could think of Tignanello, wine produced by the Antinori family since the 1970s in the Chianti Classico area. Sassicaia is a wine that was born out of the passion of Mario Cisarocchetta, my grandfather, and his desire to experiment with Cabernet in the Bolgheri area during the 1940s. So one could say that he was a real pioneer of this area, and he understood very early that the territory of Bolgheri was actually suitable for producing wines based on international varieties on the Bordeaux model. Sassicaia was firstly produced by him in order to satisfy his personal taste, and was made only to be offered to family and friends. The first commercial vintage of Sassicaia was 1968 and appeared on the market at the beginning of the 1970s. It was initially labeled as Vino da Tavola because the Bolgheri area didn't have an appellation for red wines until 1994. And since 1994, Sassicaia is labeled as Bolgheri Sassicaia DOC. So it is so far the only wine that can have that appellation on its label. The era of the Super Tuscans represents the union between tradition and innovation, as well as the desire to experiment. Today, some of these wines have become real iconic wines, and perhaps the term Super Tuscan, which is a little more generic, is less used to describe these wines, which are actually very well representing the territories where they come from. In certain production areas of Tuscany, for example in Bolgheri, which is on the coast, wines made from international grape varieties have found a true vocation and therefore have created a kind of a new tradition. So hopefully in the future, these emerging wine growing areas will continue their positive development in parallel with the more historic and well-known areas such as Brunello di Montalcino and Chianti Classico.